Dr. Susan Brown, talking to you once again from the American College of Clinical Nutrition, the American College of Nutrition here in Virginia. Right now I'm with a great friend of mine, Dr. Liz Lipsky. Liz and I have been working in nutrition a long time together, and Liz is the author of a wonderful book on digestive wellness, which is really one of the most comprehensive and popular books on digestive concerns. If you find yourself wanting to know more about the digestive system and many health problems that are related, whether it's inflammatory situations or simple digestive situations, you'll find it in the book, Digestive Wellness by Liz Lipsky. But since writing this book, Liz has been paying a lot of attention to a fascinating new area of human health, which is the microbiome. And here at this conference, actually, they're talking a lot about the bacteria that live within our gut and in our nose and in our eyes and all over our body, and the role that that bacteria plays in our health. Like Liz, for example, now I think I'm a human being, but what percentage of my cells are human and what percentage of my cells are bacteria?
Well,
what's the latest on
about 50-50.
About 50-50.
About 50-50.
Okay.
So you've got about 50-50 bacteria and human cells. And
okay.
Then the other thing is we've probably got about 10 times more viruses that live in our microbiome than bacteria.
Oh my
gosh. And then we have a lot of fungi that live there. And so when you think of it, we're really a lot like soil. Soil has the same kind of composition, and even ocean water has these microbes. They're everywhere. If you go to Grand Prismatic Pool at Yellowstone, it's boiling water and it's filled with microbes.
All these life forms. And so in other words, we focus on bacteria because we know they help digest our food and reduce inflammation in the body and whatnot, but there's viruses that can be, they aren't bothering us too much. They're symbiotes. They're
just like there are pathogens that make us sick, like strep throat or H. pylori, which contributes to ulcers. Just like we have things that make us sick,
yeah.
And we focus so much on the things that make us sick, but mostly our immune system and our microbiome is there to just be in harmony and be there to protect us. And what's interesting about this group of microbes is that they really run our metabolism, and they determine whether we're fat or we're thin. We're at a cancer conference and we're hearing that they help determine whether we're likely or not likely to develop cancers. We know that they play a big role in mental health issues, diabetes.
It's amazing.
Diabetes, and it just goes on and on. And I think someone said it a little differently yesterday, but it's kind of like who's ruling who? Like
sometimes.
I just think we're a big sack that they push us around because they make vitamins for us and
we give them a happy home.
They
don't have to do too much work in order. We give them plenty of food. You know, that's interesting, Liz, because Deepak Chopra said, after hearing about the microbiome, he said, you know, I think it's just a way bacteria have found to gain consciousness.
Yes.
Higher awareness, because it's like we want to have more awareness, so let's become a human being, you know, sort of thing.
Yeah, and the other really great thing about them is they live in these very strong communities, and so they're not terribly easy to disrupt, but the way that we live, we make it easy to disrupt them. So when we're eating too much sugar, we're feeding them, and actually often when we're craving sugar, it's them screaming at us, saying, I need sugar, feed me.
And the carbohydrates are often what they eat.
Yes.
And another interesting thing about this conference was that the bacteria also eat fibers that we don't eat, that we can't digest. And so that's very important that we get a high fiber diet.
Yes.
In fact, some of these researchers today were talking about 55 grams of fiber for cancer prevention. Now that is like usually you might say 30 grams, which is really hard to get. What do you think about that 55 grams?
You know, I think we hear so much about probiotics and taking probiotics, and what's really interesting about these fibers, and it's fibers, it's also in seaweed, so if you ever eat sushi that has nori wrapped around it, and also human breast milk, they have these things that we call prebiotics, and they're actually food for this microbiome. And they're food, and as So for example, if I eat a strawberry, and that strawberry has all kinds of these bioactive polyphenols and plant components in it, but they're not active until they get eaten, gobbled up by like these microbes in our belly.
I see.
Okay, and so they get gobbled up, and then all the goodness of the strawberry gets released, and so it works to reduce inflammation and help our eyes and our skin and protect our heart and do all these things. And so the magic is in the food. The magic is in these foods. And I don't know if you remember, but remember there was James Anderson a long time ago.
Yes.
Who wrote a book on diabetes.
Diabetes, exactly.
And he was working at the University of Kentucky doing research. And you know, with diabetics, we're always saying fewer carbohydrates, don't eat so much carbohydrate. But he said, no, let's just increase fiber.
Yeah.
And he was 40 to 60 grams a day.
Yes.
And you know, my research is kind of like, well, isn't that interesting? Because all of the diets that we know that really help rebalance digestive issues like irritable bowel syndrome or that work on diabetes, they're all very controlled about the types of carbohydrates that they have.
Right.
And I think when we get those carbohydrates is things like pinto beans and garbanzo beans and winter squash and lentils and whole grains and fruits and vegetables and
the skins of them,
and nuts and seeds. When we start getting those fibers, those have all those bioactive components that feed the microbiome and then reduce inflammation and help kind of just normalize almost everything in the body.
You know, it's really interesting if you think like the consumer might say, look, I'm tired of taking all these vitamins. Now I have to take a probiotic, then I have to take something to feed the probiotic, this prebiotic. But I guess one thing I got from this conference is really focus on the fiber. You know, controlling certainly really detrimental things like sugar, trying to keep your blood sugar in line, keep your sugar intake low, but then the fiber, which then feeds the bacteria and you naturally develop a diverse community. That was interesting too. One of the benefits, one of the things you want to see is a diverse community of all these microbes and the high fiber diets. So take a look at some fiber counts on the foods. You have to eat lots of vegetables, and of course that's what we're seeing all over here.
Yes.
Remember the recent blog we're doing on 99 ways to get more vegetables? Well, you want to get that 9-10 servings of vegetables a day, fruits and vegetables, very important.
Because, you know, just eating, there's a study from England a couple years ago. People who eat at least 7 servings of vegetables and fruits have live longer with fewer diseases, have 25% less cancers.
Yes.
And 31% less heart attacks and strokes. Now, if we had a drug that could do that, it would be a really best-selling drug.
Yeah,
vegetables and fruits are way more fun.
Yeah. You know, we actually saw a study on happiness, that even just one day eating vegetables, the next day people tended to feel a little bit happier. So I am really pleased to have Liz here. Digestive wellness, look it up if you have a digestive concern. Liz, do you have any last thought on the microbiome? I mean, it's a whole new field. They say eventually they're going to test your microbiome and tell you what drugs to take because the microbiome metabolizes the drugs. We think we're doing a lot, but really it's our microbiome that's doing much of it. And any last minute thoughts that would be, fiber, certainly the fiber, anything else new that would help us to keep rest of?
I think, you know, stress really affects it.
That's a good point.
Eating lots of sugar really affects it. Taking antibiotics, even women who are on birth control pills.
Right.
People who are using inhalers for asthma, any kind of steroid medications. All these things can really disrupt the microbiome. So thinking about kind of every day, thinking about that the food you eat is really, with every bite of food, you're trying to decide, am I moving towards health or am I moving away from health? Right. And I think it's always kind of, people say I'm disciplined. I'm not disciplined. I just like feeling really good.
Right. And you pay attention to your body. You notice, hey, it doesn't feel really as good to eat this complicated sugar confection that I used to like.
Yeah.
Well, it's great. Thanks a lot, Liz.
Welcome. This was fun.
It was fun. And you're going to see the world of nutrition is exploding. Stay touched, and we'll try to bring you more information. Take care. Bye-bye.